Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Momita, moderator for the conference call. Welcome to Q1 FY22 earnings conference call of CSB Bank, hosted by Axis Capital Limited. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star and then zero on your touchtone telephone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I would now like to hand over the floor to Mr. Sameer Bhise. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you, Momita. Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us today for this call. From the management team of CSB Bank, we today have Mr. Rajendran, MD and CEO, Mr. Pralay Mondal, President, Retail, SME, Technology and Operations, Mr. B.K. Divakar, Chief Financial Officer, and Mr. Ganesan, who is Head, Credit Monitoring and Recovery. Without much ado, I would want to hand over the call to Rajendran, sir. Over to you, sir, who will give a brief on how he is seeing the environment. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, friends. The first quarter of financial year 2022 has been one of gloom, with the second wave of COVID creating havoc on lives and livelihoods, affecting every walks of economic activity. Given the situation, there were insurmountable challenges in growing the business volumes and in getting the dues collected from customers. This round, in our case at least, the impact was more on the gold loan and retail borrowers than on SME and corporates. On gold loan front, it was double whammy with the collection challenges compounded by the reverting back to 75% LTV regime from 90% enjoyed from August 2020 to March 2021. Despite all these constraints, I'm happy to note that we could post a profit of 61 crore for the first quarter of financial year 2022, which is higher than Q1 of financial year 2021 and that of the last quarter of the previous year. Let me take you through the main highlights. Revenue growth. Net interest income grows by 45% year-on-year. Q-on-Q, there has been a decrease of 3%, mainly because of interest reversal on gold loan NPAs, totaling to 24 crore in Q1.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stay connected while we connect the management team back on the call. Ladies and gentlemen, please stay connected while we connect the management team back on the call. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your patience. Please stay connected while we connect the management team back on the call.
Okay. Sorry for the disturbance. There is some problem in the connectivity. May continue. Net interest income grown by 45% year on year. Q-on-Q, there has been a decrease of 3%, mainly because of interest reversal on gold NPA, totaling to 24 crores in Q1. As gold NPAs have gone from 46 crores to 354 crores. Gold loan NPA loss is not significant, and hence we have to recover the NPA, including interest, in the coming months, and this hit has to be viewed as temporary. On the expectation of yield taking an upward movement, we are very cautious in the treasury operation.
I'm sorry to interrupt, sir. I'm sorry to interrupt, sir. So if you could please bring the phone a little bit closer to you because the voice is not very clear.
Okay. On the expectation of yield taking an upward movement, we are very cautious in the treasury operations and have been unwinding the trading positions and parking the funds mainly in short-term securities. However, we are continuing with the trading operations very selectively and watchfully. The treasury profits are down by 55% on year-on-year basis. On a quarter-on-quarter basis, there is improvement. Modified duration of our trading book is 0.55 years. Despite year-on-year decrease in treasury profits by 25%, we could post an increase of 3% in overall non-interest income year-on-year, supported by PSLC income, banca commission, processing fees, etc. Q-on-Q treasury profits have increased, but other streams have reduced as many of the incomes like ATM and SME maintenance charges are collected only in last quarter, while many others like bank commission, banca commission, LCBG commission, processing fee, etc., have a natural propensity to be high in the last quarter of any fiscal. NIM. The quarterly NIM that was at 4.06 as on 30/6/2020 increased to 5.14 as on 30/6/21. Though we were able to contain the cost of deposits to 4.48% during the quarter, both the advance and investment yields decreased by 66 basis points and 56 basis points respectively from Q1 of financial year 21. But for the interest reversal on account of gold loan NPAs amounting to approximately 24 crores, the interest yield on advances would have been almost at par with the Q4 level. With the opening up of the economy, we are optimistic in recovering and upgrading the gold loan NPAs, and this will hopefully restore the NIM to previous size. Staff cost increased by 13% year on year as the number of staff increased from 3,337 to 4,508 or by 35%. Year on Q, there is a decrease of 46% as Q4 of financial year 21 had a fair share of extraordinary EAS 15 provision. If you remember, 38 crore change in mortality rate impact and around 14 crores VRS for awards of impact. Also, no DA provision for retirees has been found required for Q1 of financial year 22, since the DA for June 21 is less than that of March 21. In Q4 of financial year 21, we had debited profit and loss account by rupees 23 crores towards DA for retirees against nil for the first quarter of 22. Non-staff OPEX increased year-on-year basis, mainly due to increase in depreciation, payouts to dealers and business correspondents, rentals due to opening of new branches, etc. Number of branches have increased from 413 to 514, and this is the main contributing factor for the increase. Q on Q, there is decrease of 17%, mainly because of depreciation, where there was a one-time hit of around 11 crores in Q4 due to reduction of useful lives of its assets. Operating profit. Bank has recorded an operating profit of 179.78 crores as on 30/6/2021, with an increase of about 39% each on year-on-year and Q-on-Q basis. This could be achieved despite the challenges posed by the external environment. As compared to Q1 of financial year 20, the Q4 of financial year 21 is at 66.77 versus 50.26. The cost income ratio has improved to 47.74% for the first quarter of financial year 22. Thus, we could bring cost income ratio below 50%, and it is likely to remain there in the coming quarters as well. Net profit. Net profit for the first quarter stood at 61 crores, vis-a-vis 54 crores in the corresponding period of previous year. For Q1 financial year 21, PAT was 43 crores. This is after provisioning or providing for 92 crores towards provision for NPA on gold loans. In Q1 of 22, we continued the accelerated provisioning policy for SME other than gold as well as NPA accounts. The additional provision held over and above RBI regulations amount to approximately 298 crores. Balance sheet growth. Deposits and advances have grown by 14% and 23% respectively on year-on-year basis. CASA deposits also grew by 29% year-on-year. CASA ratio has improved to 29.23% as on 30/6/2020 to 33.09% as on 30/6/2021. Or by about 4%. Deposits are reduced by 3% Q-on-Q, mainly because bank opted not to replace the 660 crores of certificate deposits, which matured in June 2021. Advances are reduced by 4% Q-on-Q, mainly because a fall in gold loan portfolio by 8%, due to challenges posed by reverting back to 70% LTV regime, compounded by recovery and collections affected by lockdown. In segments like SME, MSME, assignments, MFIs, etc., we were very cautious on fresh disbursements in view of the uncertain business environment. Two-wheeler dealerships were closed most of the days in the quarter in the key geographies that we operate, affecting the two-wheeler finance segment. On gold loans, while NPA surged has affected the results adversely, it may be noted that economic loss is expected to be not significant, as we hardly have any MTM losses on the portfolio. Also, average LTV for gold loan, which was at 83% in March, has been brought down to 75% as of date. Asset quality and provisioning. Our gross NPA on 36/2021 is 4.88%, whereas it was 3.51 on 36/2021 and 2.68 as on 31/3/2021. Net NPA as on 36/2021 is at 3.21 as against 1.17% at the previous quarter and 1.74% on 36/2021. Similarly, PCR decreased from 85% to 70%, considering the accelerated standard asset provision in excess of the RBI requirement, amounting to 104 crores this year, works out to 77%. As most seems to be over on gold loan front, we will be able to recover the gold loan NPS in the coming months, which will help to improve the asset quality metrics and PCR. We were considerate and sympathetic towards the problems of the gold loan customers, and extended a breathing time to them for repayment by taking a toll on our balance sheet. This gesture of goodwill from bank side is expected to earn the appreciation of the customers who were loyal to the bank all these days. As on 36/2021, restructured advances as a percentage of total advances only 0.48%. The amount outstanding in guaranteed emergency credit line scheme as on quarter end date is about 135 crores. Overall, we are holding a standard asset provisioning of 164 crores, including the accelerated provisioning for standard assets and the provisions in excess of RBI stipulation amounts to Rs. 104 crores. Collection versus demand for the month of June 21 stood at 93%, excluding gold loans. Capital adequacy. Our capital adequacy has improved to 21.37% for Q1 of 21 quarter end, to 21.63 due to decrease in credit and market risk-weighted assets. Leverage ratio has improved to 8.37%. Expanding the network, we have opened 11 new branches in this financial year and merged 6 unviable branches, thus taking the total network to 570. We plan to open another 50 branches in the current quarter. Once the demand picks up, we will have enormous opportunities in our priority segments, like gold loan, SME, MSME, two-wheeler, MFI, etc. The challenges in the collection front have started to alleviate and it will improve substantially in the coming months. The good thing for us is that the challenges brought by pandemic have not diverted us from our transformation journey, and we are optimistic that our clear focus and strategic initiatives will stay us on track in the path of sustainable growth and stakeholder satisfaction. We remain well capitalized and well leveraged to capitalize the economic recovery tailwind to drive strong financial and operating results in the coming quarter. I'll stop at this and take the questions from you.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. If you have a question, please press star and one on your telephone keypad and wait for your turn to ask the question. If you would like to withdraw your request, you may do so by pressing star and one again. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have any questions, please press star and one on your telephone keypad. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have any questions, please press star and one on your telephone keypad. So our first question from Mona Khetan from Dolat Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi sir, good evening. So firstly, on the gold book, you mentioned that MTM losses based on current prices would be nil in this portfolio. Is that a fair understanding?
That's right. There is no mark-to-market loss on the portfolio level.
Mm-hmm. Okay. With respect to the auctioning, are there any challenges that you're facing in the state of Kerala?
In every state there is a challenge. Okay. The politicians come in the way. The governments also interfere. They don't want us to go with the auction. And on our own also, if there is a public sentiment against it, we are not pursuing the auction. He might have given auction notices on a large scale. Normal practice is once you give an auction notice, 90% of the people come back and redeem it. Only 10% will go for auction. This time that was not the response, even though we are seeing recoveries after giving the auction notice. It's quite a bit of portion remains for auctioning. But so far what you auctioned is only 43 crores worth of loans. Out of a book of about 6,000 crores. So auction is not the main way of recovery during this period. But we will continue to give the notices with an intention to get the money back. And wherever it is feasible, we have gone ahead with auction also.
And compared to history, as a percentage of overall delinquency, are auctions a lot higher this time around?
Yeah. When compared to the previous quarters, auctions are higher this time. Normally, we don't resort to auction at all. Very, very rare in our history, right? So this time, we have to resort to auction because of two things. One is, people are not coming forward for taking the jewelry back. Because there is no social function or any compulsion for them to redeem the jewelry. They don't have the income to pay the money and roll over the loan. Normally, rollover happens in these loans. But when they come for rollover, now they have to pay the difference in the loan-to-asset value also. Because loan-to-asset value has come down from 90 to 75. So they have to pay the interest and the difference, which is a larger amount for them to pay when they are not having the regular income. So naturally, the redemption process as well as rollover process got affected during this quarter. Fortunately, the gold prices are remaining at the same level. So there is interest in the people to redeem the jewelry. I hope that we will be in a position to come out of this problem in the next two quarters.
Sure. And what would be the reason behind the sequential decline in gold tonnage from 17 tons or thereabouts to about 16 this quarter?
It is mainly because we have not done much of disbursements. It mostly focuses on recovery during this period. So naturally,
okay. And some part has been paid. Okay, and some part of gold loans have matured and to that extent.
Almost 600 crores of loans are paid back. Okay.
Okay. Got it. And on the non-gold part as well, 100 crore or thereabouts of slippage would result in a slippage ratio of 4.6%. So some color there in terms of where the delinquencies have come from. You did highlight it's from retail, but within retail, where is it that you're seeing the stress?
The slippage is mainly on the gold loan to the extent of 337 crores. And DA portfolio, that is mainly from the MFIs, whatever assignments we have taken, that has a slippage of about 11 crores. All other retail loans and SMEs have contributed for 86 crores.
Okay. And how much would it be from the two-wheelers, if anything, you have readily available?
Two-wheeler is around 56 crores.
56 crores.
Oh, sorry. 5,600 accounts, is it? Okay. Sorry. I'll give you the two-wheeler number. That's about 30 crores, right? No, sorry, Mona. NPA in two-wheeler is only 4.29.
This quarter, the slippage is 4.29.
Total outstanding NPA for the portfolio is only 6 crores.
Okay. And the slippage this quarter would be?
4.26 crores.
Okay. Okay. And, got it. And when it comes to the gold delinquency, you continue to provide 25% even for the delinquencies this quarter?
Yes. All the NPAs 25%. Other than gold, I provided 25% for all the SMEs also.
Right. And your SME book would be in the same range as 2.8% as last quarter?
SME book has come down, right?
new book has increased in compared to March.
How much?
By 110 crores.
SMA book has increased by 100 crores over and above the March level.
Increase only
460 crores or thereabouts.
460, right.
Okay, got it. And lastly, for the second consecutive quarter, we are seeing a good growth in the corporate book for you as well. So, if you could give some color around which sectors and the nature of these loans.
We have seen good demand from the corporate segment as well as SME segment. Gold loan, we are not grown. Because focus has shifted to recovery during the last quarter. Probably during this quarter, gold loan should start growing positively. Otherwise, the two-wheeler and all, the dealerships are not opened yet. Most of our dealerships are kept closed and people are not moving. So two-wheeler and all will take time. Financial inclusion and agriculture will see demand now because there's a good monsoon. The cultivation will start and then we will see good amount of demand coming for gold loans as well as agriculture loans during this quarter. And MSME also, once shops are opened for stocking, they will come back for the MSME loans. So overall, the demand will come back once the complete opening happens.
Mm-hmm. Okay. No, so I was particularly referring to the corporate book. It has continued to grow. So within the corporate, where is the growth coming from? I did notice that infra share has increased, construction share has increased. So what are the opportunities, if you could just throw some light there?
Construction is a conscious call which we have taken. So the large amount of contracts are being given by every state government because it is a turnaround strategy for the economy as a whole. So construction contractors are having good demand for credit as well as the non-fund based limits, which we are catering to it. That's a focus segment for us. The infra, we are selective on the HAM projects for the road. Both the NHAA as well as the selective state governments, we have funded some of the HAM projects. So that is one demand. And demand is coming from the solar energy and particularly the textile mills in Coimbatore and some of the industries are going for captive solar energy. As we have this account already and the cash flows are known to us, we are supporting the solar expansion also, not on a standalone basis. Most of them are put in for captive consumption by the existing industries with us. That is one area where we are supported. So infra will continue to have demand. Construction will continue to have this demand. And other area where we have grown is on the food processing, mainly on the dairy. We have done quite a bit of work. And other food processing areas also, we have taken few accounts which are doing reasonably well.
Okay, sure, thank you. I'll come back in the queue if I have any questions. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question from Mr. Anand Dama from MK Global. Please go ahead, sir.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity, sir. Gold loan book that we have a fair share even in the state of Tamil Nadu, apart from Kerala. So how is the situation in Tamil Nadu, whether you have blocks particular in terms of auctions even in the state of Tamil Nadu, or is it largely restricted to Kerala? And bulk of the NPAs that we have seen in the golden book are largely from Kerala in the current quarter, or is there a fair share even from Tamil Nadu?
No, it is from all states, not particular to any states, but Kerala situation is better. The growth has happened only outside Tamil Nadu during the last 1 year. So naturally, the NPAs are also more only from states outside Kerala. And auction is not a problem in Tamil Nadu to a large extent. There are selective pockets where we had some issues, we are not gone ahead. This 47 crores, what we are talking about might have happened only outside Kerala to a large extent. In Kerala, auctions have not taken place at all.
Okay, so situation in Kerala still remains tense.
Yeah, but the Kerala NPAs are very low. We are able to recover in Kerala.
Okay. Because I think there was basically state chief minister, saying that you are not supposed to do collections and so on. So you were under the impression that basically Kerala situation typically should be bad, right?
No. It's not that bad when compared to other states. But of course, we are not able to proceed with the collection action, right? We cannot go to the court. We cannot sell the properties. We cannot sell the gold. But persuasion is there always. We can persuade the customer to pay and get the money. That is how we are working.
Okay, sure. And so how are the recovery rates, particularly in the month of July now? I think you have given data for June, but for April, July,
May, June, all the 3 months, our recovery rate is 93% for the gold, for the other than gold portfolio. For gold portfolio, it was only 20% in April, 42% in the month of May, 46 in May and 62 in June. And this month seems to be good, of course, when we close, we have the number. July has improved a bit because a little bit of opening has happened in many parts of the country.
Okay, so it should touch about 70-75%?
Yeah, it should come.
Okay. And sir, is it possible for you to share the 30 DPD and 60 DPD par book, particularly in the golden portfolio?
Yeah, we will provide it. I'm not really having it, but we will provide it in the investor presentation itself.
Another question was about this, you know, you already have now, you know, you are again getting back into the corporate down segment. And so you talked about the road project. I agree, basically, there is a lot of demand, particularly coming from Telangana and some of these pockets and Southern India mainly. So what is the need for basically for us, you know, the size of the bank that we have basically to get into these kind of road projects where, you know, there could be inevitable delays at some point of time and being stuck again? And secondly, what is the ticket size of these loans that you would have done over
here? We have learned a lot in the works of the past mistakes. The HAM project, our loan sanctions are coming with a condition at least 2 or 3 milestone payment they should have received from the state government before we go for a disbursement. The entire contribution from the promoter should also come upfront. So the bank disbursement happens only at the last level. In many cases, by the time we disperse the loan, they have completed 80% of the road project already. And out of these loans which are sanctioned, most of them have already started the annuity payment also now. So they all completed the project. So nothing is at risk, and it's only annuity project. And we have collateral securities also. Unlike other banks, we insist on collateral securities for these HAM projects also. So we have enough collaterals as a fallback.
Okay. And sir, what is the ticket size of this loan?
Huh?
What is the ticket size of this?
These are all small loans for state government HAMs are somewhere between 30 to 60 crores maximum. Okay.
For
this is for extension of the existing roads normally. It is not a new one. So the acquisition of land and other problems are not coming up in this.
Okay.
It is maximum size is only 60 if I remember correct.
Okay, sir. And so what is basically now the average tenor of this portfolio that we would have? Or basically the portfolio is still not really big enough for us to track the tenor and stuff?
It's not big enough at this point, but I can give you the duration could be around 7 to 10 years.
Okay.
And some okay. cases we have stipulated the entire collection should come to our loan account first, then only you have to absorb the remaining amount. And some account we have given the 7 to 10 years repayment period.
Okay. And how many banks typically would be there in this project apart from us?
Most of them it is a solo for us. Okay. One or two cases we might have shared, otherwise it is solo. Normally we don't get into a consortium kind of arrangement.
Oh, great. Yeah, that's it, sir. That's it from my side. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Anna.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Mr. Suraj Das from BNK Securities. Please go ahead, sir.
Yeah, hi sir, this is Jay here. So a couple of questions, sir. One is on the gold loan, sir. Again, I think you had mentioned that some of the part of the slippages is because of the LTV management. So can you please elaborate, sir? I could not understand as to how LTV change would lead to some spike in LTV.
So when the LTV is given at 83%, 90% when they take it, we might have lent 83%. And the gold prices have gone down, we might have called for additional margin. The additional margin is not paid and we treat it as an NPA. There is one cost for NPAs coming up. And normally, on due dates, people come and pay the interest and roll it over. That is a practice in the gold loan. Now, when they come for a rollover, you will not get the 83%, but you will get only 68% today. So they have to pay the difference in 25% also to roll over the loan, apart from paying the accumulated interest. This becomes a major burden for the people. So they are not able to roll over. If they don't roll over, naturally it becomes an NPA for us. What we have extended now is that if the people are willing to pay the interest, we have allowed them to continue their loan without going for auction, because there is an intention to redeem. So there are two things which are required for loan recovery. One is intention to pay, another is ability to pay. They don't have the ability to pay because there is no income. But there is an intention to pay which is revealed by their paying the interest amount or a portion of the interest amount or principal amount. So whenever people have come forward to pay a partial amount, we allow them to continue the account in the NPA status itself without resorting to any further recovery process. And once lockdown is over, probably they will come back and ready. So we don't want to put them to a corner and ask them to act. We would like to be a little more humanitarian during this period.
Right. And part of this LTV change was because of the regulatory mandate, right?
This RBI guideline. RBI was keeping a higher LTV from August 8th to March 31st.
Correct.
On March 31st, they have gone back to the original LTV.
Right. So that has already, I mean, from this quarter onwards, that has already settled, right? So incrementally,
we have reduced it from January onwards. But when the gold price has gone down, we have not lent at a higher level. So this problem could continue only after December.
Okay. And what is the typical term for gold loan, sir? Is it like 12 months or is it even lower than that?
So we have all maturities. There are 3 months loan, there are 6 months loan. Agricultural loans means depending upon the crop which they are cultivating. We might have given for 4 months or 6 months. And the normal gold loan is for consumption purpose, it is 1 year. For SME and others, normally it is 1 year loan.
Understood. And second thing, for on restructuring, the amount that you have mentioned, is it inclusive of the proposal that you may have received, or this is the only which have already been affected? And what could be the quantum by September?
We don't have any pending proposals for restructuring as on date. Whatever has come so far, we already approved it. This includes all the numbers where we have given approval, but that's very negligible.
It is 4 crores.
Right. It is only 4 crores during this period, right?
So, sir, the person who has taken that gold loan, he did not have an option to restructure, and instead of getting into NPA, he could have, you know, because anyway you can see this kind of a temporary thing, he could have asked for restructuring or no.
It is only an accounting gimmick. Okay. Anyway, when the gold prices are going down, extending the period doesn't make sense, right? Further erosion of the margin will take place. So had we given at 63%, probably we could have thought about replacement option also. Now people are coming up to 85%, 90%, 95% of gold loan value. So restructuring and extending the period may not be the right strategy. So we have not thought about it. Of course, there is no specific request also from anyone.
And the last thing on NPA side, sir, I mean, have you already moved to daily NPA tagging on all products? Because I think all banks were supposed to pay by June, but anyway, you were following that, or part of the NPA spike is because of daily tagging that you would have implemented now?
We are having a system which is declared NPA on a daily basis. Okay, for the past 3 years it is there. We have automated our NPA processes 3 years back. So every day, once you complete 90 days, automatically that declares the account as an NPA on the 91st day, and we also make provision.
Across all products, right? Including your agreement.
Across all products on an ongoing basis.
The last question, sir, is on SME book. It looks like that the portfolio has not moved much in the last few quarters, at around 2,200 crores. What is the thought process here, and you know, what is your usual ticket size, maybe the range, yeah, which would be your kind of a sweet spot, and why is the growth and portfolio not growing? Thank you.
Our ticket size, which used to be 60, has grown to a lakh of rupees. After this loan to asset value has gone up, it has gone beyond 1.3 lakhs during the last quarter. It will remain at that level. For the gold loan company, if it was 35,000, probably they might have moved to 50,000 now. And ours is always above a lakh of rupees. It should remain around 1.25 to 1.30 average size.
Sorry, sir, the question was on SME loan, sir.
SME average ticket size will be around 2 crores.
And the average is okay, then sometimes it could be defective, but what could be your preferred range of loans at origination?
In SME?
Yes, sir.
SME, the preferred size is between 5 to 10 crores. Okay, that is the focus area, so that the concentration risk could be less. There are many SMEs which have grown with us over a period of 30, 40 years. They might have gone beyond 25 crores also.
And why? What is the thought process on the growth of this book? Because it looks like the portfolio has plateaued. I mean, it has not grown in absolute amount also.
The portfolio on outstanding basis is a flat for quite a long time. Our disbursements are high, but we continue to lose accounts to the competition. The competition offers at a much, much lower rate, which we cannot even imagine today. Right? So we don't think that is the right pricing policy. Aggressively pricing SME loans, the BBB rated accounts at 7.5%, 8% is not the ball game for us. We would like to price the risk properly. So for that reason, we might have lost quite a few accounts in the past. But still, we don't change the pricing policy. Price goes with along with the risk. So the disbursement, even though it is remaining high, the outstanding balance remains almost stagnant for quite some time. I hope the market will understand and reprice the loan shortly when the liquidity is withdrawn, excess liquidity is withdrawn. Loans will be priced properly to avoid this losing of accounts from our side.
Understood, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Mr. Sushmit Patodia from Motilal Oswal AMC. Please go ahead, sir.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Hi, sir. Good evening. Sir, if you can tell us, so two questions. One is on this 43 crores of gold loan auction that you have done. What would have been the realization? Was there any LGD you would have taken?
We have taken a hit of roughly about a crore of rupees. This will be treated as a unsecured loan in our book and provided completely, 100% provision immediately done. But the recovery process will continue. We will be in a position to recover a substantial portion of it.
Okay, got it. So 1 crore loss on 43 crores of auction.
Yeah.
Got it. And so second question is if you can give us some details on progress of Mr. Kalei and his team's where are they now? What is happening?
Well, would you like to take the question?
Can I get the question again? Sorry, I just missed it.
So, hi, Pralay. Hi, Sushmit here from Motilal.
Hi.
Just wanted to know, where are we in terms of product launches? What is, if you can give us some color on the progress. Yeah.
Yeah. So, let's divide into two parts. One is what we have already launched. Products like, two-wheelers, micro MSME and things like that. So they're doing well. And obviously, as the market opens up and the economy opens up, we will aggressively grow those businesses because we are launching some of the credit scorecards and some of the, templated designs to scale those businesses up. So that's one part. In addition, what we're doing is we plan to launch ACF, relaunch education loans, selectively do personal loans for our internal customers, and also look at some entry-level commercial vehicles once the economy starts opening up, and commercial equipment. So these are the few products which we have. In fact, we have just hired some of these people. They have not yet joined. They will join in another 3 months' time after the notice period. So once they join, meanwhile, the credit team is working on some of these, policies and products of these. Some of these products were there before, so we are relaunching them. Some of them will be new. Also on the payment side, we are going to enhance our capability on the micro ATMs. And on the acquiring side, we are looking at how to scale these businesses a little bit more. And on the prepaid and credit card side, we're also looking at partnerships at this point of time. On the SME side, we are going to focus on, while we'll do everywhere, because that's the mainstay of our business, but we need to focus on 60 branches in 10 locations and come as kind of SME branches where they will be looking at various products and services by which we can give special attention to these customers to being focused there in those branches. And on the home loan side, while we have our own product, but that's more on the affordable side or a slightly higher IRR products, but for the this thing, we are planning to tie up with one of the leading players for not to retain our premium customers who should be taking those products from us, and that's why we are tying up with somebody. So we will, with all this, we'll have a reasonable suite of products to complement already what we are strong on, like gold loans and agri. On the agri side, we are planning to launch 2-3 products on the affordable finance and some of those products which we plan to launch, because we have fair amount of distribution in the deeper geography, and we are saying that while you have done well on KCC and MFI, but now we need to leverage those distribution through some of the commodities and some of the other products which are planning, including farm mechanization and small MSME kind of products, etc. So those are the kind of things which we're looking at. So a fairly large plan, but this will all be on the back of technology platforms which we'll create. Our new CTO has joined us, so he will be joining us in India by August, middle of August. So once he comes in, we will create a full digital vision for the bank and work on it. Those things take 12 to 18 months, but we will start working on the digital vision of the bank beyond the bread and butter digital, like net banking, UPI, mobile banking. All those things are doing well. But we will look at, our slightly different phase of digital banking, which we will update you as and when the time comes. So I hope I could answer your question.
Thank you, Pravin. Rajendra, sir, one more question. Is this LTV adjustment to 75%, has it happened across the book or only for the customers whose loan was due in the last 3-4 months?
No, on due dates, it will happen. Okay, if they have the margin, then we don't ask them to pay. So as and when the loans are falling due, they have to pay the money. Now, as a prudential measure, we have moved for getting the additional margins to the extent possible, where the loan asset value is above 75%. But normally it happens only at the time of the due date. If it is 6 months loan at the end of 6 months, if it is a 1 year loan at the end of 1 year.
Thank you, sir. So we'll move on with the next question. It comes from Mr. Aman Ilahi from Investec. Please go ahead, sir.
Hi, sir. Thank you for taking my question. So firstly, for gold loans, I just wanted to understand what your outlook is. So obviously, this quarter, we've had an 8% impact because of the LTV reset. And our current disclosures again show that our LTVs are at 77%, which is still a tad higher than the minimum 75% LTV that RBI has sort of set. So what is the outlook for gold loan for the full year FY22?
When the normalcy is restored, the demand for gold loan will go up again. But this is the only loan which the people can get without much formality. Any other loan today, because most of the banks and NBFCs are going slow on the unsecured loans and business loans. So most of the business people will come back for gold loan, because it is the only option available to them. And once the lockdowns are withdrawn, I'm seeing a huge surge in demand for gold loan, and we will definitely have our market share of it.
Right.
Sir.
And sir, you know, another change which I noticed was, you know, during the time of filing of our RHP, we had indicated that our average ticket size was in the range of 60,000-70,000. So currently, that is now upwards of 1 lakh, around 1.1, 1.2 lakh. So is that a conscious change that we have done, or is that more an outcome of what the demand environment is?
Mainly it is because of the increase in the value of the gold. Okay. So when the value of the gold goes up, the average ticket size goes up for all of us, all the money, all the lenders, we have seen an uptick in the size along with the gold value going up, one thing. And the segment which you are attacking, we are in the middle segment, right? The middle class, middle segment, we are there. The lower segment goes to the private financiers and the NBFCs. So naturally, this ticket size was around a lakh of rupees for quite some time now. And it is likely to go up further because those who are not borrowed on the gold loan earlier are coming to the gold loan market now. These are all in the middle class people. So naturally, the ticket size is likely to move up further.
All right. And sir, on the restructuring part, I just wanted to understand, have we restructured gold loan accounts? So you tried to answer the question, but I think I missed that part.
So we have not done restructuring in the gold loan. Okay. We never thought about it also. Because gold loan is linked to the value of the gold, and the cash flows are not assessed at the time of giving the gold loan. And repayment schedules are not fixed. It's only a bullet payment. So normally they have to come. Only way of replacement is that they can come and roll over. That is the kind of replacement. After paying the interest, they can roll over, which normally happens. This time it is not happening because of the difference in the loan to asset value. Otherwise, replacement is not offered. Neither we have offered nor anybody in the market has offered the replacement option to the gold loans.
No, thank you. And so lastly, obviously, on the liability side, you know, our deposit rates are among the lowest within the regional banks. And, you know, our LCR, that has also come down from 230-40% levels to around 170. Still higher versus the minimum regulatory requirement. But on an ongoing basis, you know, our current NIMs are much higher than what we would like to maintain on an ongoing basis. So, what is the steady-state LCR that we would want to maintain on our book?
Now, the desired rate is above 4.5% always. And when the market is favorable, naturally, money is available at a much cheaper rate today. And our balance sheet is not a growing balance sheet for quite some time. You might have seen only last year, we have grown a bit on the liability side. So, we always had an excess liability which we are deploying in the market. So, and we were very choosy in accepting the term deposits also. Our rates are always maintained at a very low level when compared to the competition. So, this has helped us to keep the cost of deposit at the lowest level. And going forward, the balance sheet is growing at the desired level of 20-30%. Probably the cost of deposit will also go up. We may have to give little more attractive rates to attract the retail deposits.
Thank you, sir. That's it.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Mr. Pankaj Muraka from Renifa Investments. Please go ahead, sir.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sir, couple of questions. One, your gold loan book is already 35% of your book. So, how do you see that evolving as a percentage of your overall loan book?
There is no target amount for proportion for the gold loan per se. It all depends on the opportunities. I don't mind growing the gold book if there is an opportunity in the market. At the same time, there are opportunities coming up in other segments also. There is a good demand coming from corporate segment and SME segment. If that book is growing, probably as a proportion, gold loan will come down. But as a policy, we will not slow down on the gold loan. There is no worry on the gold loan side. If you look at the yield, if you look at the credit cost, there is nothing like gold loan to contribute to that to me. So we will continue to grow our gold loan book as and when opportunities are there.
So over the next 2-3 years, how will it be? Will it be around similar level?
In a growing balance sheet, it may come down proportionately because the other retail businesses will also pick up. I was talking about various new products getting introduced in the retail. Similarly, SME also many opportunities coming, and we are seeing capex demand is coming from the corporates also. As a proportion, gold loan may go down, but growth rates will remain high for the gold loan for the next 2-3 years.
And yield on gold loan is about 11.5%, I think that's what you said in the presentation.
That's 11.5% is the effective yield because of the NPAs, you know. Naturally, about 24 crores of interest is not recognized. So, when we recover the money along with the interest, this yield will go up. Last quarter, it was 12.81. The same, it has come down mainly because of the NPA interest is recredited.
But the gold loan NBFC is there, it is much higher. So, where is the gap?
I'm not getting your question. Gold loan?
The NBFC is on gold loan side. Their yield on their book is much higher. It runs into high teens and, you know, in some cases even higher than 20% also.
So, as a bank, I cannot go up to that level. I think maybe another 0.5%, 1% increase is possible, not beyond that level. Our customer segments are different. Their ticket size is very small, and their sourcing methodology is different. And apart from the cost of operations also will be high at the low ticket size. So this is optimum size and optimum yield. Maybe another 0.5%, 1% increase is possible, but not beyond that.
And finally, for the bank as a whole, meaning on the construct you are trying to build, what should be normalized credit cost on an annualized basis?
Target is below 1% always.
Below 1% you said, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Mr. VP Rajesh from Banyan Capital Advisors. Please go ahead, sir.
Hi. Thanks for the opportunity. So just trying to understand, you said there was a loss of 1 crore on the gold loan auctions, and you're trying to recover that. So I was just wondering, given the size of these loans, is it worth pursuing the delinquent customers? How does that work?
And the sales force which is bringing these proposals, they will be in charge of recovery also. Okay. We have 600 people working for the sales in gold loan. They will be recovering this money. Even before this also, last time in 2013-14, we had about 1.5 crores as a gold loan deficit in the auctions on a small portfolio of about 3,000 crores, out of which more than 80 lakhs is recovered over a period. And all these cases are reported to CIBIL as a default. Okay. When they go to the next institution for borrowing, any borrowing, they have to clear this amount, then only they will get the credit. It also helps us, even without your effort also, this money will be paid back to get clearance. So it's not a major challenge. Not much of efforts and money is spent on this collection.
Got it.
This will happen.
I see. My second question is, you were talking about the other guys giving loans to your SME customers at a very cheap rate. So isn't there a concern that they will pick off your best customers by giving them lower loans and therefore the quality of our book incrementally will go down? What are you doing to protect against that?
Not necessarily. So in the SME, always the risk is high. Okay. If you look at the SME book of any bank, 5-6% NPA is quite common there. Ultimate loss may be less because most of them are collaterally secured. But NPA is a risky, SME is a risky portfolio. You cannot price it at such fine prices.
Sure.
You will not have protect your margins. So maybe in the process, one or two customers may be lost. We have seen many customers have come back also. They were with us for 30, 35 years. They left us for the company is offering 0.5%. But when they go to the bank, they understand there are other ways of making money. Okay. Non-transparent ways of charging the customers. So they come back. So the comfort level with this bank will be much more. Some of the customers might have been lost. It's okay. But if you start reducing it, then it becomes a rat race and you will lose your margins.
I see. And my last question is, what's your sense on the growth of our loan book over the next 3 to 5 years?
The minimum growth is 25% for loan on an ongoing basis. in the current year, if there could be challenges.
Okay, so you're saying we'll...
between 20 to 25%, we must have pushed it.
Okay. No problem. We are thank small you, sir, balance. And all the best.
The size of the balance sheet is very small. It should not be a big challenge.
Thank you, sir.
Understood. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Nashi Shah from Echo General Insurance. Please go ahead.
Hello, sir. Yeah, thank you for this opportunity. I think I must have joined the call late or something, but my first question would be, would you be able to help me out with the breakup of the NPAs in the book?
Gold is 337 crores. The direct assignment is 11 crores and others are 86 crores. These are the first slippages.
All right, okay, sir. And the OTR book would be largely which segment of the loan book?
Come again?
So I know that you all haven't restructured any gold loan. So apart from that, the OTR constitutes mainly of the retail book or which part of the loan book that you all have?
Mostly it is SME book. Restructuring and the SME.
All right. And in the MSME book, you all have a new MSME book. So what does that include? What's the difference?
There was a legacy book which we still run, okay, which is done in the conventional way of CC account, OD account, like that. Now the new MSME is only term loans, right? 3-year loan, 2-year loan. They are all parameterized and schemes are there. And that is managed separately, and we are trying to get out of the legacy book and convert it into the new model.
Okay, all right, sir. That's all. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Mr. Harsh Shah from Edelweiss. Please go ahead, sir.
Hi, sorry. This is Harsh Shah from L&T Mutual Fund. So basically my question is regarding first, what is the percentage of your book, gold loan book, which currently has 85% plus LTV?
Roughly it should be 15%. Above
85%. And as and when the repricing, as and when the repricing will happen, this will again come down, right?
Yeah, the book size will come down.
Okay. And secondly, sir, if you can just talk about a little bit on the operational side of it. So bank as a entity was still allowed to operate in most of the countries, whereas your peer sets, which are your NBFC peers, they were not allowed to operate. So optically speaking, they must be having a bit more stress than what you have been having. So for CSB Bank as an entity, what kind of operational challenges did we face in Q1?
Mainly getting the people to the office, right? So because of the lockdown, customers are not able to come to the office. And initial stages, even the staff movement was very restricted. And staff are reluctant to come to the office. Staff are reluctant to go to the field for recovery. When they go also, they are not able to meet the customer. Customers are reluctant to meet the staff who go for recovery. We never had a recovery team for gold loan, to be frank. So it was automatic, right? There is no effort for recovery in the gold loan specially. It's very, very rare. So this time we have set up a call center wherein we call these customers and the potential NPA customers and talk to them and tell them if you are having money, we will come and collect it. Our people go and collect the money, either as a partial payment, interest payment, or the full closure also. So we have extended some customized solutions for this problem. Then only this kind of recovery is possible. So when compared to the, that's what we were giving the number earlier, the month of April, the recovery was only 20%. And in the month of May, it has improved to 44 to 46%. And in the month of June, it has gone to 61%. For the current month, it could be much better. It is improving. When relaxation comes, this will definitely improve a lot.
Right, sir. So you also mentioned that there is willingness of customers to pay back. So without giving any absolute figure, where do you see this GNPA figure coming down maybe in a quarter or two. So even if you miss one quarter because of extended lockdown, that's fine. But towards the end of FY22, where do you see this figure settling down?
I'll give some indication. See, last March, the SMA 0, 1 and 2 in gold is 954 crores. For the June end, the SMA numbers is only 300 odd crores. So the likely slippages for the September will be much less when compared to what happened in the last quarter. And it will go down further during the third quarter. In the fourth quarter, it will come to the normal level. Bring it down substantially.
Next quarter slippages will be lower, that was a given, but that will also be supported by higher recoveries, right?
Naturally, yes.
Okay, so optically means you are expecting this current GNPA number to go down quite a bit by the end of FY22.
So, yeah. If you just to see the past track record, in the September, when they not announced the NPAs at all, the provisional NPAs were what it was, and it has come down in December. December gold NPAs are 124 crores, and the opening happened, the NPA has come down to 44 crores in March. So that will happen during the current phase also. Once this third phase is also over, I think it should come down to the normal level.
Okay, that's very helpful, sir. Thank you and all the best.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Mr. Jehan Mada from Nirmal Bank. Please go ahead, sir.
Good evening, sir. Sir, how is the on-ground situation in terms of disbursements across gold and non-gold book? And if you were to compare the Q4 run rate of disbursements, how behind are we from the Q4 levels?
Only 30% I can say across the board. Only 30% is the disbursement happening when compared to the Q4 of last year.
Okay, okay. So probably for full recovery to happen, it will take us, it might happen in Q3 once things normalize.
All depends upon the next wave and the extent of it.
Right, right. Okay. Sir, second question is on credit cost. I could not hear you properly. Our earlier guidance in earlier calls was that steady state it should be around 1%. But in current year, can we expect that by the exit of current year in Q4 we will reach that level?
Hopefully, yes. By March end, we must be in a position to reach that, what we believe.
Yeah, so probably next, every subsequent quarter there should be a declining trend.
There should be an improvement, yes.
Okay, okay, fine. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Ronit Shah from Hexagon H Fund. Please go ahead, sir.
Yeah. Hello. So my question is, like, you have said that book will be increasing by 25%. So it's like, till this year it will grow by 25%. Like, for the FY22, do we expect it to grow by 22% or in the
24
years.
So the target, original target was 25% growth. We have to tamper down a bit. Probably 20 to 25% is what we are expecting at this point, with the hope that the economy will recover and there will be huge demand for loans in general.
Yeah, and so what we are expecting about our NIMs, with net interest margin, like, from the Q4 to Q1 level, we have...
I would not like to give a forward-looking statement like that, but our internal targets are around 20%.
Okay. Okay, that's all from my side.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Nirmal Bari from Sameeksha Capital. Please go ahead, sir.
Yes, sir. Thanks for taking my questions. My first question is on the gold NPA that we have recognized. So is it possible to give what would be the LTV in those portfolios?
we have it in. Less than 75% is 32 crores, 75 to 90% is 147 crores, 90 to 100% is 173 crores, above 100% is about 27 crores.
Okay, and when we say above 100%, this includes the interest component as well, or just the principal?
Updated interest component also.
Okay. And my second question is on the growth that you said internal target for the current year is about 20%. So last year the growth was largely driven by gold loans. So in the current year, since there is an LTV reduction from 90% to 75%, what segments are we looking at to achieve this 20% kind of growth?
It should be all-round growth for the current year, because for the first time we are seeing enough demand coming from corporate segment as well as SME segment also. And agriculture has done well last year, and current year also monsoon is good in the areas where we are operating. So the demand from agriculture also should be good. And NBFCs have totally shied away from the bank credit for quite some time now. Our NBFC portfolio has come down by 50%. Probably when the demand comes back, NBFCs will also start borrowing. So that will also help us to grow the credit. And we are very low on DA at this point of time, because when the COVID started, we are shied away from this DA portfolio. So DA, PTC, we have not done much. So if the recovery rates improve, probably we will look at the assignment portfolios and PTC portfolios also again. It is another area of growth which can happen. Gold loan will come back. Certainly gold loan demand will also come back. And we are opening large number of branches. Last year we have opened 100 branches. They are all active in the market now. And there are another 200 branches likely to be opened during the current year. And at least 70-80 branches will come up in the first half year. So they will also contribute to the growth.
Okay. The third question is on assignments. The assignment loan that we do, is there some credit improvement or some kind of credit improvement that is provided on those loans, or we do it for our PSLC purpose and there is no credit improvement involved?
No, there is no need for PSLC for us. We are sellers in the PSLC. Quarter after quarter, you must see. We make a good amount of money on the PSLC. Say for this quarter alone, we have made 12 crores by selling PSLC. We have achieved all the priority sector targets. Maybe one or two segments, sub-segments. When we need, we might have sold something and bought micro loans alone. We were running short by a small amount, which we might have bought to a certain extent, because we have not done DA transactions. Normally, this micro comes from the microfinance company. When DA is not the option, other option is to go and buy the PSLC certificate. That seems to be the right option during the last quarter, considering the recovery rates of the MFIs today. So that was the right strategy. When the recovery rates improve, we'll go back to the PTC and DA transaction.
Okay. And my last question is on the retail loans that we have given in the advances mix of 1162 crores. So, if you can give a further breakup of how much of it would be like housing and how much of it would be unsecured and others, that would be
about 400 crores is from the LAP and 300 crores is housing loan. So about 200 crores should be deposit loans, loans against deposits. 100 crores are regular staff members, and unsecured is negligible.
Okay, we don't do personal loans and other unsecured.
We don't do. Some personal loans are there for some corporate arrangements, but that is not significant.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Ms. Mona Khaitan from Dolat Capital. Please go ahead, ma'am.
So I just had two additional clarifications. So, what would be the incremental yield in the corporate book from the solar and the road investments that you're making?
Road, how much we have? Solar and road breakup is available.
total employees only all. Entire employees itself is 1.81% of our gross
settlement. Amount quantum by? The entire employee is only 1.81% of our book today, which includes gold and, which includes road and solar also. Not much at this point of time.
So I was referring to the yields, the lending yields incrementally from the corporate book.
Solar is comparatively less and road is better. The corporate book yield should be around 9.5%.
That is the for the entire portfolio?
Entire portfolio.
But what could it be, say, incrementally? Could you give a rough range? Would it be, say, less than 8% or...
Rates are coming down in the market, so naturally incremental lending may happen between 8.5 to 9%.
Okay, got it. And secondly, on the gold book, this 5,600 crore or so, is it all organic or do we have some purchase portfolio as well?
And we have purchase portfolio, but it is not accounted in the gold loan. That is accounted in the DA. Yeah, we have maybe about 500 crores of a direct assignment portfolio in gold, but that is accounted as an assignment portfolio, not as a gold loan portfolio.
Okay, so 5,600 crore is all organic.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay, thanks so much, sir. Thank you and all the best.
Thank you. The next question from Mr. Sanjay Kumar from iThought PMS. Please go ahead, sir.
Hi, sir. So, one question on the gold book. You said the main reason for NPA in gold book is because of the LTV management. But fundamentally, I want to understand, customers, why are they choosing to roll over? Because they're not able to pay the principal, or you say that, or do you think that it's just, they're not able to pay just the margin money or the difference?
If you go very see, we are in the internet business for the past 100 years. Okay. We are never lost in the gold loan. And the industry used to have a loss of about 0.36%, when our losses from all reasons, NPAs, gold loan option shortage, frauds, and theft jewelry, all these risks together, it was 0.1%. There is no other business where credit loss can be contained to less than 0.1%. So these seasonal fluctuations will be there. This is a one-off event. And when we are talking about gold loan shortages, mark-to-market losses, it is not a real loss from the customer point of view. What is valued at 100 rupees for me, the replacement cost should be 115 rupees minimum for the customer if he goes for repurchasing the jewelry. And there are a lot of sentiments attached to the jewelry in any family, right? These are all the middle class families. They might have got it from their mother on vacation of the marriage. So normally they would not like to leave his jewelry. So, willingly, they will come back and redeem the jewelry. That is our experience. And we know these customers for quite a long time. So we have told our managers, don't force the sales. And if you are confident of recovering, get a portion of the amount paid now to show their intention. Either a portion of the interest. Most of them have paid the full interest and a part of the principal also. So that is how the system works. So, yes, okay. You will see after two, three quarters when we see the number, you will also understand how it works.
Okay. My point was about the rollover, because we also have some loss in tonnages from 17 point odd to 16 point, but not much option also, right? It was just around 50 crores. So the tonnage loss, did it go to other banks, NBFCs, or has it gone out of the system?
Do not go to other NBFCs because it is nobody is giving that kind of value. Sometimes it goes to the private money lenders. Private money lenders may give even 130%, 120% of the value of the jewelry because they will be recovering on a daily basis or a monthly basis, something like that. So sometimes it goes to the private money lenders where the loan asset value could be much higher. Otherwise, under the present circumstances, shifting to another bank or another NBFC may not happen.
Okay. So banks still do have an upper hand over NBFC in gold loans. So we are seeing market share gains, right?
I always say, if we are able to deliver like the NBFC, NBFCs will become history.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Just one request. You did give out the SMA numbers in one of the previous questions. If you could give that in the presentation and maybe the NPA breakups also, that would be great, sir.
Yeah, I'll make it available to you when I'm posting this in the website.
So you'll include this number also.
Thank you. All the best.
No, no, not at all. The semi website, when we are posting, we'll include it. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have any questions, please press star and one on your telephone keypad. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have any questions, please press star and one on your telephone keypad. So there are no further questions. Now I hand over the floor to Mr. Rajendran for closing comments. Please go ahead, sir.
Thank you, friends, for having made it on a tough day like this. I'm told entire Bombay is having heavy rains and problems in movement. And for staying late and keeping up in this. And we are very confident whatever problems we are facing in the gold loan or any other area for that matter is only temporary. And the conversation with the clients indicate that there should not be much challenges in the recovery of the loans once the lockdowns are removed. And we are also confident about the recovery, and the demand for loans will also be very substantial once the recovery starts, and the bank will have a much better time going forward. Let us hope for the best and pray for the best. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I hand over the floor to Mr. Sameer Bhise for closing comments.
Yeah, hi. Thank you, everyone, for joining us today this evening. Thank you to the management of CSB Bank Limited for giving us this opportunity to host the call. That's it for now. Thank you, and all the best. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Sameer. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, with this, we conclude our conference call for today. Thank you for your participation and for using Dur Sabha's conference call service. You may all disconnect your lines now. Thank you and have a good evening.